Two of the bigger disappointments in the first quarter of the season doing battle here as we get this one underway. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Levis to throw off play action. That'll be complete to Okonkwo. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run. Well, how about a deep ball on the first play from scrimmage, putting that secondary on notice?
Brandon, all I remember when I was a player is that we always took a test the night before the game about teams' tendencies and what they plan to do. I'm not sure we think deep ball right out of the gate and putting us back on our heels.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game and leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Too far downfield, something those linemen have to watch out for, and that time it costs them. Levis now on second down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. Levis on third down. He'll complete this one to Okonkwo. And almost, but not quite. Needed 10. He got 9. Fourth down. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Back to throw, it's Levis. He's got his target. That's complete. Touchdown. Treylon Burks, his first touchdown on the year. And the Wizards' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Well, Charles, he's still a young signal caller in this league, second year in the NFL. But I don't know if last year as a rookie, if he would have worked through his progressions like he did on that touchdown pass.
I think you're right about that. We're seeing him grow up right in front of our eyes because when he went to his primary read, he recognized that they were all over that, so he continued to survey the field, picked up another target, delivered a pass exactly where it needed to be. A very mature play for the second-year quarterback.
Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. Come out throwing here to start the drive. Now a short one to Gesicki. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. Now they'll change things up. Right back to him on first down. And a pretty good burst there as they get this across midfield and down to the 46. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attempt. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
For this defense, very strong in that victory from a week ago.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with 3 interceptions in that game.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up 3rd down. Okay, right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Whistle blown. A timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. And that's their 2nd charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on 4th and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. They go for it on 4th down, and it pays off big time as they pick up 29. So after the big play on 4th, here's 1st and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
When a drive goes this long, you have to give a lot of credit to the guys up front, those big fellas, because the offensive line is putting something together that allows them to continue to control the ball. I know a lot of people think they get fatigued on a long drive. Actually, a lot of times the reverse happens. They actually get energized because they're controlling the ball and they're the ones dictating to the defense.
And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. A stop there on 3rd. They could have held him to 3 on this opening drive. Now they have to bow their necks on 1st and goal.
And if I'm looking at this from the offense's point of view, that's a big-time pickup right there. And I'd go right at him with another momentum play. I'd go quickly and attack them, because right now they probably have their heads down a little bit since they didn't stop them on 3rd down.
And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter now, and it's our home team with possession. As they come up now, second and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. His second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Aviators are an extra point away now from tying this ball game.
Boy, two long, sustained drives by each team to start things out. It's kind of similar to how the pitch clock has shortened baseball games. That means we'll be out of here quickly if we get a few more drives like that. We're in the second quarter now, and we've only had one drive apiece, each of which have ended with touchdowns.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. Okay, great. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Levis out of the shotgun now. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down. Gets it out wide quickly. Burks with it. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it's second down.
Traylon Burks, a 6-yard pickup, brings up second and 4 at the 37-yard line.
Here we go, here we go. Alert, alert.
He gets it to Burks again. Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. They'll run on first down with Singletary, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. His throw incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jonathan Jones. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They'll start in excellent field position following the INT. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Ready.
to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. A beautiful. Evades the tackle and now some space. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Rookie quarterback, rookie running back. They team up there to pick up the first.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Ready, fight. Second and 10. Keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. 5 yards. Now it's third and five.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry. And they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
He'll look to throw. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up. It's 7. Well, the incompletion, but now we also have an injured player. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and 5. They'll set up a throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And as a result, possession switches hands. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Levis looking to throw. And that one goes incomplete on the drive. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0-for-3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th and 2. They'll go for it and run a little touch pass here. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. So good starting field position for him here as they come up 1st and 10 right at the 50-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. In trouble, and he's taken down. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up 2nd.
But when you see a quarterback retreating away from the line of scrimmage toward the other goal line like that, usually doesn't end well.
You're exactly right about that. Normally, if they're moving from side to side, they've got a chance maybe to get back upfield. He was trying to shake defenders and extend the play.
but it doesn't work out very well for them at all. You need those extra yards on the other side of the line of scrimmage. Now you're digging a hole for your offense.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play, but sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They're going to look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. It'll be a pickup of 16, but they'll remain short of the marker, and it's fourth down. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? Looking to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Back to throw again. Going right side here, and that's complete. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going, and right now it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Forced out to his left. And it's caught. Touchdown. Mike Gesicki as the first half is winding down. And the Aviators have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Extra point by Ryland up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I thought at first he tried to run, but he just kept buying time to his right. Finally, nothing there. He wisely gets rid of it.
This is a quick incompletion. This is likely the last play here of this first half. One final shot before the half. Here's Levis. That's to the sideline and incomplete. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. We welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. A one touchdown ball game, 14-7 our scores. We get back at it on EA Sports. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback.
offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. And now an audible here into something else. Here's second and eight. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. A little jet sweep to start the drive. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. 11 yards on the pickup there. But just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense, because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
Singletary trying the left side, and he maneuvers up the middle for three, and it's second down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Right back to Singletary on second down. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Here's Levis. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They run here with Singletary, and he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. Again, it'll be Singletary. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Devin Singletary, his second touchdown on the season.
So a strong drive here to lead off this third quarter. That has him an extra point away from tying things up.
And, partner, this is pretty much what they envisioned when they were sitting there in the locker room thinking about getting things going to start here in the third quarter. Getting out there, a field goal would have been fine. But going ahead and scoring here, extra point away from tying things up, that's exactly how they drew it up on the board.
Extra point right down the middle, and we are tied at 14. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. No run back here for Jones, a touchback. Offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They start from scratch here, so to speak. 14 all following the interception last time that led to a score. Now they've got it first and 10. 55 yards rushing for him now to this point.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles.
Okay,
we just saw the linebacker make that play.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attempt. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earn a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Well, looks like they'll move things around here. Now here's a throw. It's complete. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Out of the gun now on third down. Flushed out right. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
I haven't met a quarterback yet that didn't enter the league with a massive chip on his shoulder. If he wasn't a first-round pick, they want to show the league that they made a big mistake. Determined to get the first down there, no hesitation at all to tuck it and go. I bet he would have tried running through their entire defense if it meant reaching that marker.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Now a timeout called for by the defense. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He'll buy some time right. And his throw is incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets 2 more stops. They can keep them out of that area.
Third quarter, all tied up. This is 2nd and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. That is caught inside the 5. But he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. Mark that as a gain of 16 to set him up first and goal.
Let's go. 19, Tiger, 19, 72, Timberwolf.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. Touchdown. From 4 yards out. And the Aviators have moved out in front here in the final minute of the third quarter. Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. Back out is the kicker, Ryland, and he'll send this one away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive, so we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go?
Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Levis to throw off play action. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
It's complete, Burks. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. Fourth down, Levis. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter play. Back now here on EA Sports as we are set to bring you the home stretch here, the fourth quarter. First down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain. Second down.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
A quick throw complete into the flat out left. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
The offense on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5. He'll drop to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. Great effort there. His second touchdown of the game, his 3rd on the year. And the Aviators look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Rylan, up and good. And the lead now up to 14. Now Rylan now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, Charles, you remember their last drive. They went for it on 4th down, didn't get it, but you understand why they did in this close game late. Now, though, the road back is even tougher.
Yeah, no doubt about it, and it was fair to look back and say the 4th down was the moment where this one was decided. But as you mentioned, understandable about why they went for it. But, hey, a lot of credit to the guys on the defensive side of the ball. They knew they'd have to defend in that situation, and they got it done.
This 2nd and 4. They go right back to Singletary. This will be a short gain of 3 before he's brought down at the 22. And they're going to speed things up here. Levis on 3rd and 1. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have 1st down yardage. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the 2nd touchdown. You got the 1st one for the 2nd one to even matter.
A give up the middle to Singletary. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Singletary here running out of the gun. And another negative play there as they stop him again. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
The last two plays each lose a yard. They'll try to move forward here on third and 12. Levis. And he'll get this underneath to Singletary. And he's going to get this to the 31, but that is still well short of what he needed. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Desperation time now. Here's Levis. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field.
Here we go.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Defensively, no doubt they need a quick stop. Offensively here, maybe do you put it in the air on second down, or do you go ahead and keep it on the ground, keep that clock moving?
A lot of people would ask that question, partner, because sometimes throwing the ball might actually be the path of least resistance. But in this case, it's a matter of trust. How much do you trust your quarterback? Because you throw the ball and it goes awry, you really don't look smart as a coach.
Yeah, and then you stop that clock. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. They got to get it to the 21 here on third down. On play action, they'll throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. A much better effort we're seeing from him under center this week versus last week when he threw four picks.
He has thrown the one in this game, but you're right. When you cut it down from four the previous week, and we always talk about adjustments, well, he made some in practice, and he continues to work on it during the game. I'm sure he's getting plenty of reminders about how to stay in the moment, stay focused on the task.
And he's got him in the driver's seat here in the fourth quarter. They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. Stop short. Down at the one. Had the great move, but couldn't get all the way to the end zone. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
Ready, break.
They'll try to run this one in. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
But when the ball snapped from the three down near the goal line, I think in days gone by we thought many teams would run the football. But on third down in today's game, I expect them to throw it. A little counterintuitive there. They tried to run it, instead spilled for a loss.
Now back to throw. Touchdown! A great play there. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Aviators look like they're about to put an end to their two-game losing streak as they add on to their lead. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility, look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak? And they really came together with a good week of practice.
So after the field goal, Ryland back out as he'll send this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone.
And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. But probably not much that they can do at this point, CD. Down three scores late in the fourth quarter. This is going to be a little too much to overcome, you would think.
Yeah, they'll go down swinging, but in the end, I think we saw the writing on the wall a while back because one team was clearly better than the other in this one. And while it didn't quite reach blowout status, I think we knew who was going to win this one well before we got to this stage.
On first down, Levis. He'll get this out wide to Singletary. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. It's a gain of seven. Brings up second and three. Levis from the gun. Now he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that one. He's fortunate it was just incomplete and not intercepted.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
The decision made for them. They've got to go. It's fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Escaping the pressure right. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that will force a turnover on downs. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee.
Let's go now.
The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. This was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of